Hi, everybody.
Hi.
Hello, all four of you. Thanks for tuning in. It's the Charlie and Heather Show. Here we are. Craig is with us tonight. Hey, Craig. So probably Andrea, too. Hey, Craig and Andrea. And Ginny is with us. So that means probably Ginny and Bernie. So this is a... What's wrong, Heather?
I'm trying to do this post, and I put starting hotly because my computer is a little bit messed up sometimes. And now I'm trying to edit it, and it won't let me type stuff, and I don't quite know why, so... Talk amongst yourselves. Hi, everybody.
I was going to share the show. But
okay, you share the show, and then I'll just figure out what the heck I'm going to do. I'm going to just say hi to all seven people we have now. We're up to seven, Charlie.
Okay, I'll start talking when we have 10.
All right. Hey, Sue's here. Hi, Sue.
Your Aunt Sue?
Yes, my Auntie Sue. Oh, that's Auntie nice. Silly Putty, as she is known throughout parts of this country.
Really?
Yes.
I never Other heard people. That.
Yes, Auntie Silly Putty. And then there's, I also call her Auntie Soupy.
Do you?
Yes. My Aunt Soupy. You've never heard me call her Soupy?
I don't know, maybe.
Well, it's true.
I can't find the show.
Well, get back to that. I'll share it then.
What? Yeah, but I like to share it on my page.
Okay.
I don't know. It doesn't seem to be here. Oh, well, hi, everybody. Oh, there it is.
There we go. Save. I got it now. Okay. Now I need to share the show. Okay. This is boring for people to watch us share. Okay, just talk.
Okay. Never mind. I'm not going to share it on my page tonight. So if you're looking for the show, you're going to just have to follow us on the Charlie and Heather page. So we got Aunt Sue watching and Julie's watching. Hello, Julie. And Carol McLean is here from Vancouver. And show sharing can be a little challenging. Yeah. Maybe I'll try to do it while Heather's singing or something. We need a producer. We need you, Craig. We need you here. And you could actually set up our sound and then you could like take care of everything. You could like share it and whatever. Anyway, sometimes Craig said, I haven't figured out the secret sauce yet. Sometimes the show starts, and as you guys know, we go to that little Charlie and Heather logo, and I wait till a couple people are watching, and then I start the 30-second video. And usually if I go to Facebook, the show pops up and I just hit share and it does. But then other times I'm sharing it on the Charlie and Heather page, and there's no sense sharing it there because it's already there. Yeah. Anyway,
I do that all the time, but I figured it out.
Your parents are here.
Hey.
Hello, Don and Sharon. Hello, McIntyres. Oh, yeah, right. That's in the wrong spot. Yeah. Anyway, hi, everybody. Tonight is our lazy show because we had a lazy weekend. I've been writing. Craig would love to produce our show. Okay.
Sounds good. You're hired.
We'll come to Quill. We'll be there.
Yeah.
We'll do it in your studio because you have all the sound set up. I bought, just so everybody knows, we bought a soundboard and microphones, and Craig taught us how to sort of set it up, but I think we're missing a couple cables or something. But it was so long ago, it was like 2 or 3 months ago, that I don't remember how to do it. So we keep talking about setting up sound so that we can have a better sound quality. Because if you watch Craig and Andrea, our friends, do the show, Our Living Room Live, and they have a really full sound because Anne plays piano and
Craig
plays
drums, and they have mics and really nice fancy sound. And yeah, they're all fancy and professional sounding.
And we're just one sad little mic.
Hello.
Oh, well. Anyway, but we are gonna someday we're gonna have better sound.
Yeah.
If we're not so lazy. Because that's the theme today is the lazy show. So let's see. Harley's watching too.
Hey, Sylvia Harley and Harley. Sylvia, hi.
Hello, Harley and Sylvia. What's Craig saying? You know I'd be there as your producer if I could. I know. We'd love that.
You guys need to move back home. That's it. Just done.
Move to the East Coast. Yeah. Amherst in particular.
Yeah.
Carol Bennett's watching. Hello, Carol. Anyway, when I'm writing, and I if you guys watch the show, you know I've been writing for this. I was writing the first chapter of my new book, which is profiles of female singers who were either born or based their careers in Nova Scotia. And I wrote a chapter about Carol Baker, and I think I mentioned that. Anyway, it was supposed to be between 6,000 and 7,000 words, and it was 16,000 words. And then we're about to publish the soft cover version of, I wrote a book about Stompin' Tom Connors. Case I've never mentioned
Plug.
That before.
Plug.
And they're doing a soft cover. And I found out some stuff since I wrote this, like there were family members I couldn't reach and I didn't know how many kids Tom had that he actually acknowledged and stuff. And so anyway, they asked me to write an afterword. So I wrote that and that was another 6,000 words. So I've written like 22,000 words in the last month. And a whole book is usually 80,000 to 90,000 words. I didn't know that before I wrote books, but in case you didn't know. So I've written a quarter of a book in the last month. So all that to say, yeah, I've been ignoring you pretty much
a little bit,
all the time. So we haven't had a weekend off, but then I turned in the chapter about a week ago, and then on Friday, Thursday or Friday, I turned in the new afterword, and I talked to my editor, and they're happy, and so I have had the weekend free. So we had a whole weekend with nothing to do.
So good.
And it was absolutely glorious. It was fabulous. Today we worked on the show, and we'll just say, okay, well, let's do some more hellos, and then we'll come back to our lazy weekend.
Hey, Deb.
Hello, Charlie and Heather. It sounds great. Oh, thanks, Deb. I'm glad it sounds okay. We do have a digital mic.
It's a pretty good mic, but there's only one we have to share.
Yeah.
Oh, hey,
and
Elsa.
Elsa's watching in Campbellton. Hello,
Aunt Elsa.
I call her Aunt Elsa too, even though I think, have I even met her?
I don't think so,
but I feel like an hour. Hello, Blaine. Blaine Totten's watching.
Hey, Blaine.
Hey, and Craig says, what? You wrote a book? Yeah, I actually, shocking. Craig, I wrote two. I wrote this one about Stomp and Tom, and then I wrote this one about Rita McNeil. And right now, I'm not what I seem. I'm working on my third. Anyone who watches
the
show,
that's a big surprise to everybody in the audience.
Yeah. I tell everybody every week, wow, Charlie, the productivity, you must feel amazing. Yeah, sort of. I still feel like I'm lazy, though.
Yeah.
I never really get over that. Anyway, but we are lazy this weekend.
We are lazy.
This weekend, we did nothing. Well, okay, I lied, because today we did stuff. But yesterday, we sat on the couch, and I've mentioned we're doing a keto diet, but we cheat once a week. So we cheated yesterday, and we just sat on the couch and watched Netflix or Crave or whatever, just stream TV.
Watch TV. It's fabulous.
It, all day, like for 12 hours and eight. I ate so much, I felt sick when I went to bed. oh, look what I discovered. We'll probably show it backwards, but oh my God, I love Girl Guide cookies. You know, the chocolate covered ones that they put out once a year. They do the boring, you know, chocolate vanilla, but then they do the chocolate covered ones. I found these at Walmart the
chocolate
other day.
Mint.
Chocolate mint fudge covered Oreos. And Heather doesn't like mint, so I don't even have to share.
It's a true story.
So I asked Heather how many would be too many to eat, and she said a whole box.
A whole box is too many.
So I didn't eat the whole box. There's still a few left for next week.
Just kidding. There's more than that.
Craig said, tell me more about what? About the food or our TV watching? I'm not sure.
We'll get into that, I'm sure.
Okay. Yeah. You can ask a question and we'll answer, because we didn't really plan, because tonight's the lazy show. Look, I didn't even wear my black shirt, and Heather's wearing a hoodie.
You're lucky I'm wearing a bra.
She's barely wearing a bra. She's wearing this tube thing that she calls it. It's like a tube
top. It's like a sport bra is what it is.
It looks like a tube top.
Like,
but my mother, it looks like a tube top my mother wore in the 70s.
No, but it's got shoulder straps. It's not a tube top.
Well, they used to call them a tube top. And because it
tube
holds her boobs.
Tube top is literally a tube that just goes around this way. But this is like a sports bra. It goes like, you know.
Supposed to support her boobs. So I call it her tubie.
Because he thinks they make my boobs look like a tube.
Anyway, I think it's amusing. Anyway, Heather's wearing her tubie. Yep. And I'm wearing, Heather's parents actually bought this for me. It says the good father instead of the godfather. Get it? Anyway, because
I'm wearing a school shirt. Oh,
yeah,
that's it. I know it looks like it says Oreo, but it says OREC,
Oxford Regional Education Center, something like that.
Yeah,
so okay, so Aunt Sue says, okay, Heather Bridgerton, watch it.
I've heard
we literally talked about it last night.
We started to watch SNL last night at
Saturday Night Live,
and the guy who was hosting is the Duke from Bridgerton. So,
and we were like, everybody's saying good things about that. We should watch it.
Yeah.
So, although it's she just said, okay, Heather.
I know.
So you're supposed to watch it alone?
No, just you're busy.
Oh, well, I'll watch it with you though.
Okay.
When we're being lazy, Behind Her Eyes, Netflix. It's dark and twisty. Oh, okay, cool.
Cool.
We'll check it out. I don't know what it is, but I'll check it out. And Carol Bennett says, I will be glad when you get your book finished.
Thanks. Me too.
I've talked to my editor, and she likes the first chapter about Carol Baker. She said she didn't know. Anyway, she found it interesting. But because I wrote so much, we're not going to do 12 profiles now, because she said, I don't see how we can cut this down to 6,000 words. Let's keep it long and we'll do less profiles. So I only have to write about 8 people. So today I started researching Sarah McLachlan. That's who you'll be hearing about for the next month. Nonstop. I already started today with Heather. I said, did you know Sarah McLachlan was adopted? Which I didn't know.
I didn't know that either.
There you go. Anyway, Leslie
Ann
Ferguson. Oh my God, lose the bra, Charlie. I'm not wearing one.
I am.
Heather's wearing the bra. Sue says the Duke makes her melt. That's what Saturday Night Live was all about.
Oh, how handsome was, he is.
How handsome
and stuff,
he is, and everybody loves him.
Everything he does, everybody was like, ah!
And so I say, we can watch that and you can fall in love with
Sounds
him, Heather.
Sounds good. All right.
Oh, Charlie, we would move home in a snap someday, maybe 5 years. Oh, we'd love that.
Yes,
that'd
please.
Be so much fun. I'm so old though, Anne. I might be too old to do a show by then.
No.
Anyway, okay. Ah, Laura's finally with us.
Hey,
Laura and Keith
Laura
are with
Keith.
Us. Hey, yay. And Craig, I'll try that one, Blaine. Oh, he's going to try that TV show. Craig, I never did answer your question. Tell me more, but I apologize. Anyway, so we had a lazy weekend. So when it came time to prepare the show today, can't wait to read your next book, says Andrea. Thanks, Anne. I can't wait either. I could send you the chapter on Carol Baker if you want to read it. But only if you'll tell me it's good, because if you say it sucks, I won't be able to finish. Okay, here's what's kind of funny. It's really comfortable.
I got it from Knix, K-N-I-X online. It's so good.
Like
it's
an ad showed up in your Facebook.
Yeah, it's just on my Facebook and I just clicked it and it was so good.
Usually she wears like this giant hoodie/sweater thing.
Like, yeah, it's like a blanket hoodie, one of those giant
hours
hoodies.
A day.
But it's like it mutes the sound of my strings, so because it's so big. So I'm not gonna wear it.
Anyway, Leslie says, right? You're not wearing that torture device? Yeah, I know. I have worn a bra, they're not comfortable.
Yeah.
Because I played Lola when I was Lola in Lola Star Build Her Dream.
And Ma.
Yeah, I played women a few times and worn a bra. They're not very comfortable.
No.
Anyway, so we were really lazy, but then today we did do some work, so we had to do some work on the show. So Heather started working on the lazy song because we'd been so lazy yesterday. Oh, and I cut my fingernails and toenails today, so that was a big day. it was. I posted about it on Facebook.
You had to post about it online.
And people related, because it's a lot of work. We were talking about this at the cottage one day, and I said, it's hard to do your toenails when you're chubby. And I am less chubby than I used to be, but I still got a bit of a belly. And it's hard to get flexible, like to get my baby toenail and stuff. And my sister-in-law, Jan, said, oh, I cut Mark's. And I said, her husband. And I said, Heather, why don't you do that? And she said,
nope.
Yeah.
And then not going to happen.
Dave McClellan commented on Facebook, said, get Heather to do it. She still said no.
Nope.
My Aunt Carol, who watches this show, Carol and Rick, she said, I do hubbies, no problem. Heather will not cut my toenails.
Nope.
I said, what if I'm like old and can't do it?
I'll say as soon as you are incapable, but up till then you are capable. Yeah. So
anyway, I did do some shoveling and did some cleaning in the kitchen, did some dishes, cut some toenails. You did some dishes.
I did some dishes.
You did the dishes. I didn't do
that. I worked on songs.
Yeah. Anyway, so we did do so. Today wasn't super lazy, but I didn't bother putting on my little black shirt that makes me look skinny.
And he's wearing his pajama bottoms too.
I am. Yeah. But I don't need to stand up and show you that because it's just attractive. Okay, we got a couple more comments here. So what else are we saying?
We're getting too many comments.
Oh, wait, we already said that. Okay, Andrea, ooh, I've seen those ads. I'll look into it. There you go.
They're
You're doing
it.
Ads
yep,
for Knix.
I like it.
Maybe we could get a sponsorship from them.
Maybe.
You could wear just the bra on air.
Nope.
I said, productivity. Well, thanks. Exactly. I cut my toenails and fingernails in one day. Good job. Yes, it is. Thank you. Thank you, Bernie. And you look good, Cousin Charlie.
Aw,
thanks, Leslie.
Aww.
I lost, as of today, yesterday, 28.6 pounds. So I think I can say 30. I feel like
close
that's
enough.
Yeah. But I probably gained 5 yesterday because these are delicious. And that was just one of my 12 treats I had over the course of the day.
I gorged on gummy worms. I got the gummy bloat. Ooh.
Deb says, I'm with you, Heather. No toenails.
Thank you.
Okay. I said to my kids once, there are 4 of them. And I said, you guys are lucky that there's 4 of you. Cause when I'm old and somebody has to change my diapers, you know, there's 4 of you to take care of me. And my son, Adam, said, Heather's half your age. She can do it.
I said, thanks, Adam.
She's only 8 years younger than me. She's
only
not half
I'm
my
not
age.
Half.
No. And we're getting closer all the time.
All right.
Because when I was 16, you were half my age.
I was.
But now that I'm 40, you're only 32, and that's not as much of a difference. Wow, great loss, Charlie. What was that?
Your weight loss.
Oh, the weight loss. Thank you. Thanks. Yeah, I'm really happy about it. Thank you very much. 28.5 pounds go. Well, thank you. And you've lost a bunch, but Heather doesn't like scales.
I don't step on the scales. So
she's guessing she's because
my pants are loose.
So she's guessing she probably lost at least 20 or so as well.
Something like
anyway,
that.
Anyway, 20 more to go. And then I'll just eat all the time and then I'll have to lose it all again. I think that's how diets work, isn't it?
Yeah, that's how it works.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway,
that's good for your heart.
Well, thanks, Sue. You're very sweet. Okay. In honor of our lazy day, Heather's going to do a song. And what's the song called, Heather?
It's the Lazy Song.
How appropriate is that?
It's very appropriate, I think.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, you're going to have to scroll for me, too.
Okay, do you want me to start the song, or do you think you've got the key? Or
no, I got the key now.
Okay.
Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just want to lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone, so leave a message at the tone. Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything. I'm gonna kick my feet up and stare at the fan. Turn the TV on, throw my hand in my pants. Nobody's gonna tell me I can't. I'll be lying on the couch, just chilling in my snuggie. Click to MTV, so they can teach me how to Dougie. Because in my castle, I'm the freaking man. Oh, yes, I said it. I said it. I said it because I can. Today, I don't feel like doing anything. I just want to lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone to leave a message at the tone. Because today I swear I'm not doing anything, nothing at all. Ooh, 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 nothing at all. Ooh, 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 ooh. Tomorrow, tomorrow I'll wake up, use a P90X, meet a really nice girl, have some really nice sex. She's gonna scream out, this is great. I might mess around and get my college degree. Bet my old man will be so proud of me. Sorry, Pops, you'll just have to wait. Oh, yes, I said it. I said it. I said it because I can. Today I don't feel like doing anything. I just want to lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone to leave a message at the tone. Because today I swear I'm not doing anything. No, I ain't gonna comb my hair. Because I ain't going anywhere. No, 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 no. I'll just strut in my birthday suit. Let everything hang loose. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, today I don't feel like doing anything. I just wanna lay in my bed. Don't feel like picking up my phone to leave a message at the tone. Cause today I swear I'm not doing anything, nothing at all. Ooh, 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 nothing at all. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Hey, there we go. Look at that. Okay, nice job there, girl.
Thank you.
I like that song. We used to drive around in the car. We have a happy list on our phone. They're not even all happy songs. They're just songs that make us happy because we like them, and then we sing. When we lived in Halifax, we used to sing that FU song a lot.
You see me driving around town with a girl I love, and I'm like,
thank you. But we'd say the F word and like at other drivers.
Really loud and stuff. Yeah. It was anyway. Good.
Okay. So we got some more comments here, which is good because you know what? You guys know I always lay out the show. And right now we're supposed to talk about me cutting my toenails and we already did it. So
awesome.
Yeah, I got nothing to talk about. So thank goodness we have some comments.
Yay.
So what do we have here? I love chocolate mint. We can eat those when we go for a drive listening to Anne Murray. I'd love that, Andrea. I can't think of a better way to spend an afternoon than driving around singing Anne Murray. And oh, you think you should be involved in some way?
A little, maybe.
Okay, sure. But would you drive around? You don't like Anne Murray or Mint. So I'm just saying that would be fun.
I'll drive around.
Okay.
I like to drive.
You could have a different treat. But you got to listen to Anne Murray. You both look amazing. Thank you, Andrea.
Thank you.
Leslie Ann, your cousin, says,
we wear our hair the exact same way. Only difference is mine is way whiter these days. That's cute. Yes, I like this just because it's easy. It pulls it off my face, gets it out of my neck. It's nice.
Yours is pretty white on top.
Yeah, I'm pretty white through here, gotta say.
Yeah, but anyway, okay. Your aunt Anne, not easy.
Hey,
she's impressed
Anne.
With the weight loss and the music. Aw,
thank you.
Thanks, and thanks for watching, Anne. Okay. Oh my goodness,
look at all these.
We got
comments.
So many comments.
Oh my god,
we can just go. Can't go wrong with Bruno. I know. I love Bruno Mars. He's very cool. He reminds me of like a '50s singer in some ways.
Yeah, very much.
Jimmy Kaiser, loved this song. Haven't heard it in ages. Great job, Heather.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's not the kind of song you would think of as being when you do on uke. But
no, but it's fun in the uke. I think it is.
I have days like that, Heather. We had a weekend like that. Carly's watching.
Hey, Carly.
Our friend Carly, that probably means Dave's watching too. Our friends,
hey,
Carly
Dave.
And Dave. Carly and Heather have a little duo called Harmony Girls, but they never get to sing together anymore because of freaking COVID.
Stupid COVID.
Anyway, when things get better, we'll have
little band.
We should have a special Harmony Girls show.
Oh, yes, please.
Just you and Carly sing and I'll just talk. Maybe Dave can hang out with us too. Perfect choice. Nice job, Heather,
thank
says
you.
Blaine. And that's a great song. Love it. Oh, look, you got applause and great,
oh my
Heather.
Goodness.
Look at all the compliments you got.
So nice.
Yeah. Julie says, why don't you like Anne?
Just not my cup of tea. Just
She thinks that Anne, and I disagree, Julie, because I love Anne. And if it, don't tell Anne if you're talking to her, because, you know, I'd have her over to the house and Heather would pretend. But she thinks
I fake it good.
You think all her songs sound
I think
the same,
she's
she
good.
Doesn't sing with emotion.
Yeah. I just find, and I find her vibrato a little like too much for my taste and stuff. It's just not my taste. That's all. Just, I get no beef. I think she's a great singer, but she's just, and there's lovely songs that I go, that's a great song, and I do like them, but.
And when I play some of her older stuff.
Yes. I like some of the older stuff and everything, but just.
She's not your cup of tea.
She's just not my cup of tea.
That's right. Mom's birthday's tomorrow. Oh, your Aunt Elsa's birthday tomorrow.
Happy birthday, Aunt Elsa.
Happy Aunt birthday. Will she be 91?
Happy Aunt birthday.
Is that what I said?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Aunt Elsa. Will she be 91?
I believe so, yes.
Oh, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Next week, you'll have to do a song she likes.
Yes.
I don't know what, but we'll have to figure it out.
I know what she likes.
Okay. Julie says, Bruno reminds me of Michael Jackson.
Yes, that too. I've always said that too. Yeah, there's a couple songs that he sings that are
And Harmony Girls show, says Carly, she's in. And Julie says, that's cool. She understands. And you don't, like, you love her songs.
I do. I think she picks great songs. Like I got no, in fact, I picked two songs tonight.
We're doing two Anne Murray songs.
Though there are other people. Songs that Anne covered, so you know.
But to me, they're Anne Murray songs because I love.
So
Anne
yeah,
Murray.
Like she picks great songs. It's just her voice is just not like
it just yeah,
not my thing.
And then your Aunt Sue says, "Thank God, Heather, you see the light about you know who."
I might have learned my distaste of Anne Murray from my Auntie Sue, but whatever.
We all have different tastes. Like everybody, you like Weird Al.
That's true.
I don't get
We're
it.
Doing a Weird Al song tonight too.
Yeah, we are. Coming up. Yes, 91. Wow, hey, that's
Donna.
Impressive.
That's Good my job. Cousin Donna, too.
Okay. Hey, Donna, you got your whole family here.
I do.
You got your mom and your dad and your dad's sister and your mom's two sisters and two cousins.
That's right.
It's pretty much the Heather family show.
Oh, like you've got all of your you've got your Boston cousins.
Oh yeah, yeah. I've got my Boston family, like cousins and aunt. Not that you guys, but I mean your
Western
cousins. I mean your immediate family though, like you know, your brother isn't watching though.
No,
I guess. So thank you, Darlene and Laura for watching and Fran. That's the only family I have watching. And then, oh, boo, says Sue. I don't know what that was about, but
I think she's booing. I don't know. Anne Murray, maybe.
Okay. Julie loves Weird Al too. Anyway. So what I was going to say was I was going to bring you up to date about cutting my fingernails and toenails. And I was going to say, that's what's up with us. Hey, there's a song called What's Up?
Oh, all right.
That Heather could sing for you. Anne says, Sue said, I like Weird Al, but Anne is too weird. Oh, Sue. Anyway, yeah, so you're going to do a song called What's Up?
Yeah.
It's by Four Non-Blondes. Okay, when we first started doing our show, Heather would suggest songs that I had never heard of before, and they were often songs from the 90s. Because when I graduated from university in 86, I started to discover new music. I stopped listening to the radio. I wasn't really listening to pop music. And that's when I kind of get into Ella Fitzgerald and Frank Sinatra. I learned a lot of jazz and like that kind of old standards. I love that stuff. And I was also listening to a lot of singer-songwriters from the 70s.
So country music and stuff.
And country music. I was really into...
But he stopped listening to the radio and pop music and stuff.
So I knew nothing about 90s music. So every time Heather plays a 90s song, I'm like, never heard of it. So this is one that I actually like now because she's played it so much. And I said, why don't you do that song? Hey, Charlie, we are family. That's true. There you go, Ginny. You're all family, really, in my heart.
Charlie and Heather show family.
Yeah, I'm just overwhelmed. Carly says one of my favorites. There you go. Oh, wait, is Mark? My brother's watching.
Mark's watching, too. See, there you go.
See,
you've got some family,
Anne.
Too.
I know. Pick on Anne. Pick on Anne tonight. I hope she's not watching. Not that we're friends. She doesn't know we exist. Anne says, it's important that you count all cut toenails and fingernails and discard. Yes,
yes, please.
I keep very close track of them. Yeah. I'm not going to talk about that. Don't worry. Okay, here's what I think. If you put them in your hand when you're done, it smells like Parmesan cheese. And I don't know why, but when I say that, Heather gets really grossed out. So sniff your toenails sometimes.
Oh, see, that's the gross part. Sniff your toenails.
But see, I knew that's what that look was about, wasn't it?
Yes,
you were
it was.
Scared I was going to tell that story. Yes, I had no intention of talking about it until she gave me that look. And I was like, okay, I'll tell it. And it's like, it's not like I shower often and stuff. I don't know. Maybe you don't know if yours smell like Parmesan
cheese. Because I don't sniff my toenails.
So I count them. I make sure there's 10. I give them a sniff and I throw them out.
Gross.
Anyway.
That's why I don't want to cut your toenails.
Blaine says he loves this song. Nobody's liking them. Nobody wants to talk about their toenails.
No.
Nobody
Can
else
I just do my song now?
Okay. Do your song. Is Craig throwing up? I think he is. I think just a sec. Let me see. What's that? Oh, that's a little pukey thing,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah. See, people are on my side now with the toenails.
Mark says all covered in cheese.
Oh, gross.
Exactly.
Oh, God. Ooh, with
parm cheese. Yes,
oh,
that's right.
See?
Blaine says that's called fungus hair.
No,
it's just normal toenails. Anyway, okay. They're lovely. They're not all like discolored or anything. Like you see on TV, you
know,
they have this horrible toenail.
No, we're done with this now.
Mine aren't like that. They're just normal. They're cute little toes. If I could lift my toes, I would show you. But I can't. So I would Heather sing a song.
"25 years of my life and still trying to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination. I realized quickly when I knew I should that the world was made up of a brotherhood of men, for whatever that means. And so I cry sometimes when I'm lying in bed just to get it all out, what's in my head, and I'm feeling a little peculiar. And I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath, get real high, and I scream at the top of my lungs, what's going on? And I say, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And I say, hey, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I said, hey, what's going on? And I'd cry, oh my God, do I try all the time in this institution? And I pray, oh my God, do I pray every single day for a revolution. And so I cry sometimes when I'm lying in bed just to get it all out, what's in my head, and I'm feeling a little peculiar. And so I wake in the morning and I step outside and I take a deep breath, get real high, and I scream at the top of my lungs, what's going on? And I say, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? And I say, hey, yeah, yeah, hey, yeah, yeah. I said, hey, what's going on? 25 years of my life and still trying to get up that great big hill of hope for a destination.
Hey, there we go. That ended a little soon. I wasn't ready.
Sorry.
I thought you had more to come.
Nope.
I meant to say my brother Mark is watching, so that probably means his wife Jan is watching. We didn't give a shout out to Jan. So hi, Mark and Jan.
And hey,
they have a new dog, Gemma.
Gemma.
Gemma's probably watching. That's for Gemma. Cute little puppy they've got. Okay. Now, your father commented. Uh-oh. He said, let's go back to a show about nothing. Enough with bras and toenails. Now I know why I don't eat Parmesan cheese. Yeah, we have nothing. I didn't plan on going there with the toenails, but that look.
I just gave you a look and then you went.
Yeah, because that's what you wanted me to.
No, I didn't.
Anyway, no, we got no more gross stuff, no more bras, no more underwear. I'm not wearing any because it's lazy day. I'm just in my pajamas. I ain't got no underwear.
Okay, that's what Dad's talking about. TMI. That's what we need. Okay.
Okay.
Next.
So Leslie is feeling a little peculiar, probably because we're talking about our bras and underwear.
No,
and
the song. She's feeling peculiar in the song.
I know that. It's a line from the song. I know the song now. I like it. People are saying nice things. Look, Rhonda's watching.
You.
I don't think we said hello to Rhonda.
Hi, Rhonda
yet. Hey, Rhonda. She said awesome. And your Aunt Anne said, love that one. Heather. Oh, my goodness.
Thank you.
Look
my
at this.
Goodness.
You got applause.
All these comments.
And applause.
That's exciting.
And what is peculiar is the smell of those toenails.
That's a true story.
Okay, very good, Heather. Thank you. What's going on? So good.
Oh,
good
job. Thank you.
Look at all the thanks, Heather. That was great. So many compliments. I meant so good. Yes. Yeah, I read it as so good. Thanks. And then I bet Charlie's a blast at the game of truth or dare.
Oh, there's no such thing as holding back when it comes to Charlie. He will say anything to anybody anytime.
Don't tell me secrets.
Yes.
Yeah. Anyway, you got more compliments there. Tell Uncle Donnie to get a haircut.
Which one? This one or this one?
Now, don't pick on your father. Okay.
He's
so
used to it.
So that song, that's called What's Up. But when I went to, and I remembered, I do the little banners and then I keep forgetting to put them up like there. Like it's not there really is. What's up right now. But anyway, and then the last couple of weeks I haven't put, I do them and then I forget to put them up. Anyway. But when I went to look for the song, when you search online, it's
everybody calls it what's going on
because you say over and over, what's going on? You never say what's up. Do you know why it's called what's up instead of what's going on?
No.
Because Marvin Gaye has a song called What's Going On and they didn't want to confuse it. There you go.
Clever.
Did you also know Four Non-Blondes only put out one album? That was from a song from their only album and they only existed for 5 years. And the lead singer who wrote the song, her name is Linda Perry. Did you know that?
I did know that.
Oh, did you?
Yes, she's got a really big mouth.
Did you know she's a big singer-songwriter?
Yes.
Did you? What else has she written?
I don't know.
She's written some big stuff that'll surprise you.
Oh, I can go.
Because I had nothing for the show, so I looked up stuff. I had no more stories about us because all I've been doing is writing and cutting my toenails. She also wrote Get the Party Started for Pink.
Oh.
And Beautiful.
I'm coming up, so you better get this party started.
She also wrote Christina Aguilera's
You're so beautiful, no matter what they say. Yeah.
And she co-wrote a song with Adele, and she co-wrote a song with Dolly Parton. You know that Dumplin' movie you watch?
Oh, yeah.
She wrote a song for that.
Oh, that's cute.
She's a big deal. Didn't know that. I was like, who the heck are Four
Non-Blondes? I knew that she was a songwriter and stuff, but I didn't know that much about her. She looks like the Joker. She's got a really wide mouth, especially when she sings. She's like, hey, yeah. She looks like teeth all over the place.
Well, she's a good singer, though.
Yeah, she is.
There you go. So Darlene says, Darlene just joined. Sorry, a little late. Charlie, hope you got to cut all your nails today. I did. And if you go back and watch the show, there'll be some stuff.
There's some stuff about that, but we've moved on now.
And Charlie, you are a very, very good son. Well, yeah, I try to be. Because I have a bald spot and I don't like it when people make fun of it. So you shouldn't make fun of people's bald spots. My kids, I think it was Alex, one day we were driving in the car and she said, the back of your head looks like a cupcake that somebody forgot to ice. Like they missed the spot in the middle. And I think of that whenever I see an ice cream. Yeah, son-in-law, I guess. Jim Kinney's joining us. I'm here too, by the way, just quietly listening. Well, hello, Jim. Sorry we didn't say hello to you. I didn't realize you were with us.
No.
I thought, I don't think we've seen you the last couple of weeks. I didn't know where you were.
Our audience members are very busy commenting tonight. It's great. I love it.
Which is good because this is the lazy show, meaning we didn't prepare.
We didn't plan anything.
We didn't have a lot planned. So you're going to do another song.
I am right now?
Sure. Why not?
Okay.
This is the Ann Murray song you were going to do. Okay. I call this the Ann Murray song. I'll tell the story later. But unless there's something else you wanted to talk about. Nope. Was there anything else you wanted to talk about? Okay. Anyway, Ann Murray, I know this is an Ann Murray song, but apparently some British band did it first.
The Beatles.
The Beatles. That's
some
right.
British band.
That's what they're called. Heather likes them a lot. But John Lennon met Ann Murray at a Grammy Awards. I'm sure I've told this story before. It's a famous story. Everybody knows it. And he said it was the best cover of a Beatles version. Their best cover
of a Beatles song.
Beatles song ever.
Ever. Yeah.
That's what he told Ann Murray. From Spring Hill, Nova Scotia, when she recorded You Won't See Me. So are you doing the Ann Murray version or the Beatles version? You sound more like Ann Murray, so let's go with that.
Whatever.
Here's a song called You Won't See Me.
When I call you up, your line's engaged. I have had time that was so hard to find, and I will lose my mind if you won't see me. Oh, I was doing that fancy little thing. You won't see me. I don't know why you should want to hide, but I can't get through. I won't want to stay. I don't have much to say, but I can't turn away. the days of you, they're filled with tears. And since I lost you, it feels like years. Yes, it seems so long since you've been gone. And I just can't go on if you won't see me. I finally got that little lick in the middle there.
You did. It was nice when you stopped in the middle, though, and explained what was going on.
That's well, great. You know, I feel like I have to explain
that way people can have a drink.
That's right.
Yeah, there you go. Like I was me. Just looking at my shirt. Did I say your parents got me this shirt?
Yes, you did.
Oh, yeah. There you go. Thanks, Don and Sharon. Okay, so we got a few comments here. So let's see what's going on. Blaine Totten says, "You won't see me" is my fave. And then Jim, this is back to when I said to Jim, I was glad he was here. He said, "Where else would I be? The stay-at-home order has been extended in Toronto and Peel for another 3 weeks." They're having a rough go. It's been stay at home since before Christmas, hasn't it? In Ontario?
Yeah, I think so. Yep.
The reason we started doing this show, of course, was COVID, because we were sitting at home. We couldn't like see people and we couldn't perform. And I've mentioned this before. It's like I've never gone so long in my life without doing a show. So we just started doing something from our living room. We just did it once and now we're still here. So when once COVID ends, we probably won't be doing this. But, you know, once we get it,
who knows?
You have to pay $20 to come see us somewhere because we're expensive. Not us. It won't be this. We do like a whole show. Anyway, was he ding dogs? I think what she meant to say was he doing drugs. And she was talking about John, because she wrote down here, darn autocorrect. And I was like, was he ding dogs? And I think she was talking about John Lennon saying Anne Murray
being the best.
Was he doing drugs?
Yes. I think.
Craig said he loves this tune. Leslie says, very nice.
Thank you.
Oh, no. Oh, my goodness. Where'd it go? So many things.
Oh my goodness.
Andrea said, love this song. I love that John told Anne that. Me too, Andrea. I love that story. And she nailed it. There you go. Does she mean you or Anne Murray?
I think Anne Murray.
Oh, okay. There you go. Great song, Heather. You're so good. Good dance tune for sure.
Oh, thanks.
People like you. Should I be reading all these compliments or is it going to go to your head?
No, I don't mean that. Do that.
Poor Heather didn't mean to open a can of worms. But Anne Murray, you sound fantastic as always.
It always starts something.
She knows I'm in love with Anne Murray.
Yes, it's true.
Yeah, and she's okay with it. I'm not like in love with her, like I'd run away with her, but well, maybe if she asked nicely. This is some fancy picking you go, girl. There you go.
Thank you.
I love this song. Very good, Heather, and love it. And applause.
I'm not usually a picker when it comes to the guitar or ukulele or whatever.
Just your nose. I'm joking. She doesn't pick her nose. I just thought that would fit in with the theme of this evening. You get some applause from
from Blaine. Hey, Molly.
Glad I made it in time to hear that song. Nice job, Heather.
Thanks, Molly.
Molly's our friend in the States who loves Anne Murray. And Sue says, thanks, Charlie. What did I say to Sue about Sue? Oh, that I figured out what you were saying.
Yeah.
I know you, Sue. I knew you didn't mean dig dogs. We're so glad you do this show. Lots of great laughs and entertainment.
Well, we're glad we're entertained.
It's fun for us, too. No, Heather Schmidt, Jimmy and Anne Murray. She said, you did a great job.
Well, thank you.
So there you go. Andrea says she'd run away with her. Maybe we both could.
I'm sure Anne would be open to that.
What's it called when three people get married? There's a saying.
Thruple.
We could be a thruple with Anne Murray. I hope she never watches this because I work at the Anne Murray Center. She'd think it was really creepy. Like when I help out with events.
People are like, can I help you with anything, Anne? Can I do anything? Can I be your friend, Anne? Can I come over to your cottage, Anne?
Yeah. I don't do that. Or I would have been at the cottage by now. I don't bug her. I act cool when I'm around her, but then when I'm not. Leslie says, I like Anne and I love Heather.
Aw, that's sweet.
Blaine Totten says, Heather, you're totally outnumbered tonight with Anne Murray.
I know, like most people, it's fine, whatever. Okay. I know I have a few people in my corner.
I do want to talk more about Anne, though. So you should run and get your Weird Al. We meant to bring we were supposed to do that. But I was just going to say, that, so Anne Murray and John Lennon, and I know most of you have probably seen this before, but I'm going to show this picture because I love this picture. It's a very famous picture from 1973. And it's John Lennon, Anne Murray, Harry Nilsson, who's a singer-songwriter of the era. He's got some really good music if you don't know him. Alice Cooper and Mickey Dolenz of the Monkees. And it's like, one of these things is not like the other. Anne Murray looks like totally like she doesn't belong in that group of people. But the story behind the picture was that Anne's manager at the time was a man named Shep Gordon, and he was also Alice Cooper's manager. And he got Anne a gig at the Troubadour in LA, and which was a big club that was a big deal to perform there. And Thanksgiving 1973, Alice Cooper had these group of guys, basically whoever would drink with him, his drinking buddies, they called themselves the Hollywood Vampires. So that particular night, Alice Cooper was out with John Lennon, Mickey Dolenz, and Harry Nilsson, and they were all drinking together. And Shep Gordon went and found them and said, please come see Anne at the Troubadour and get your picture taken with her, mostly as a publicity stunt. So they came over and they had this picture taken, and it ended up like in Time magazine. Here, let's move over, and then it looks like you and I are with them too. And then it looks, anyway, and it was done.
I'm telling you, like, I'm having a drink too.
It was done to make Anne look a little bit cool because she'd been on the Glenn Campbell show a lot at that point in time. And so it gave Anne a little bit of street cred. There you go. You look like you're drinking with them. And it became a famous picture and gave Anne tons of publicity. But something I didn't know today when I went looking for the picture, because I've seen it a lot, so I wanted to tell that story. Oh, by the way, also John Lennon at that point, there was about 18 months of his life he calls his lost weekend. He just drank a lot and stuff, but he broke up from Yoko and he was living with some other woman and drinking a lot and stuff. And so this happened during that era.
I didn't know he was living with another woman and stuff.
Yeah, their assistant, May Pang. There you go.
He likes the Asian women.
Show's not just about our toenails and bras tonight. We got some trivia pop culture stuff. Anyway, when I went looking for the picture, I found this. And it's Mackenzie Phillips. If you ever used to watch One Day at a Time, she was the older daughter on that show. And her father is John Phillips. She's an actress. And it's her. And it looks like the same night.
Mickey Dolenz is wearing the same outfit.
And if you look close, John Lennon has like a necklace on. And he's got it on there too.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think it's the exact same night. She was 14 and hanging out with them that same evening.
So that's maybe a little inappropriate.
Yeah, that was she's a little young for that.
A little bit.
Exactly. So anyway, what was I going to say? Oh, that was going to, yeah. I have a couple of comments. Where are we, Heather?
Our weekly Craig's, owl check.
Oh, yes, our weekly. We're gonna
time
let
to check
owl,
in with
our owl Chia pet, owl. Weird owl Chia pet. What are you drinking, Heather?
Oh, Fresca in my cute little Nightmare Before Christmas glass.
Yeah, Heather likes Fresca a lot.
I do. That's my new thing because I can't have sweets. So,
Anyway.
So I drink this and it's.
Okay. Leslie said, which woman, but I'm not sure what's. We talk so much and then I don't pay attention. Which woman was that in picture, the picture of Anne or Mackenzie Phillips?
Mackenzie Phillips, maybe?
Yeah, I don't know. She was the younger daughter.
She was the younger daughter.
Anyway, so. Oh,
my hair is driving me crazy.
So, yeah. So I was going to say Mackenzie Phillips was way too young to be out drinking with those people. She was only 14 years old.
Yeah.
So she has to go. She'll have to go.
That's a really rough segue. But
I got nothing. No, we were going to do another song. But anyway, so I love that picture. And I think it's kind of cool that it was all staged basically to get Anne some attention. Andrea says, yum. I, in case you're wondering, I'm drinking Diet Coke as always because keto cheat day is over. Yesterday you had root beer. Wasn't that more fun?
I did. Oh my goodness, that was fun.
Yesterday was fun. We had pizza, chips, and Oreos, and so many things. Yeah. Leslie says, gotcha. So I guess she know that was what she was asking. Anyway, okay. So now we're going to do a song called She'll Have to Go. It's originally recorded as He'll Have to Go. And I think it was Jim Reeves, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Who did it first?
Yeah.
And then a number of people have recorded it. But in my heart, Anne Murray recorded it and she called it Therein Lies the As If. Yeah, exactly. But Anne Murray recorded it and she changed the words to She'll Have to Go. So really you're doing the Anne Murray version of this song. It's really
well,
a Jim
I don't
Reeves.
Know. I'm anyway. Gonna try. I've got the Jim Reeves version up. So if I sing the wrong lyrics, then
I know. She might sing he, she might sing she, she might
it's,
sing.
I might be a combination throughout the song. It's
she's had
be
a hard
very
time. She did it with new lyrics today and then she kept getting messed up. Anyway, I love this. It's a beautiful old song. I'm teasing about Anne Murray. It is Anne, but it's also, you know, not. It's just a well-known song. Anyway, I love it. Here we go. So he'll have to make
put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox. Oh, sorry. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, she'll have to go. Whisper to me, tell me, do you love me true? Or is he holding you the way I do? Though love is blind, make up your mind, I've got to know. Should I hang up, or will you tell him he'll have to go? You can say the words I want to hear while you're with another man. Do you want me answer yes or no? Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, he'll have to go. I can say the words I wanna hear while you're with another man. Do you want me answer yes or no? Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, he'll have to go. I started with she and then I just forgot about it.
Yeah,
so
whatever. It doesn't matter. It was pretty.
Thank you.
Nice job there, sweetie. Andrea said, lovely, Heather.
Thank you.
It was good.
Something different, something old.
Yeah. This went from the Lazy Show to the Anne Marie Show. My apologies, Heather. Very nice job. I love your voice.
Yes.
I was planning on talking about Anne Marie anyway, because when Heather was putting the songs together, I mostly do it to bug her. I went, oh, you're doing two Anne Marie songs tonight. And she was like, no, I'm doing Beatles and a Jim Reeves. And I was like, no, you're doing two Anne Marie songs. It's kind of like a running joke with us. So it's fine.
It's a thing.
Yeah, it is. My brother Mark wrote insert Homer Simpson, and I'm not sure why. I don't know if he meant in the picture of Anne, because it came out of, I didn't see it till later. So now sometimes I get comments and then I miss the joke because it's too late. Sorry, Mark. We could insert Homer Simpson right here. He could be between us.
Don't. You know,
that's what he says, right?
Yeah.
See, I'm smart. Anyway, sorry, Mark, I didn't bring your comment up in time to catch it. Craig says applause. And those low notes are sweet.
Oh,
I was thinking, it's funny how when you say low, turn the lights down, low, it goes low.
Very low.
A little on the nose, isn't it?
A little bit, yeah.
A little bit. Anyway.
I mean, I could do it like way down low, but it doesn't sound as good as low.
Yeah,
so.
Okay, that was excellent, Heather, and love it. And Jim says he, she both work these days, perhaps for Anne Marie as well.
I know. I'm like, who cares? Gender, whatever.
Oh, the Oreos. Mark was talking about the Oreos. Homer Simpson, does he love Oreos?
Well, he likes junk food.
Oh, okay. I was Homer Simpson yesterday. I never watched The Simpsons. I know that's awful, because they've been on for 30 years and everybody loves them. And I think I'd like them.
Hey, sure.
But I know he does sit around on the couch eating. Yeah. Anyway.
Sorry, I was getting
my Aunt Char's watching.
Hi, Aunt Char.
Hey, Aunt Char. I was complaining about family, and then Mark and Jan showed up, and
everybody
then Aunt Char showed
tonight.
Up. And
yep.
Maybe Mom and Dad are watching. I don't know. They could be commenting somewhere else. Anyway, so we were going to show you. Heather has a chia pet
I got
her for Christmas. A Weird Al chia pet.
Ready for the chia progress? Ah, look at that luscious mane on Mr. Al Yankovic now. Look, it's nice and even on all sides too.
Oh, when he was started, he had a bald spot up.
He did. He was a little bald up here, but
he could almost use a trim at this point.
Well, I know he's got, especially on like on this side right here, he's getting a little droopy over here. He's he's getting a little long. Although Weird Al Yankovic has let his hair grow quite long and stuff, so you know it's almost appropriate. So and so I took a picture of it and I tweeted it hoping Al would see it, but I don't think he has. He hasn't responded anyway.
So we only have one song left and it's not an Anne Murray song. It's going to be a Weird Al song because Heather loves Weird Al and I've never let her do one of his songs before. That's I let her because it's my, I make up the whole show. Not true. I say to her, what do you want to do? And then you go, I don't know. I'm going to talk for a while before we get into this, but you could get ready if you want. You could just do instrumental while we talk about
it. You don't like it when I noodle when you talk though.
Yeah, that's true. Unless it's like underscoring to make it more dramatic or something. But no, I was just going to talk about Weird Al for a minute. Cause the song you're going to do is, I think
I'm a clone now.
So she posted,
cause that's what I tweeted. I said to on Twitter, I said, I think he's a clone now. Ha ha ha. Look at my Weird Al. And then nothing.
Yeah. Anyway, Sue said, your aunt Sue said, looks like my last name.
He does.
And Anne said, you've successfully made him weirder. Yay. It's true. He should be called Weirder Al. Can't wait. Anyway, so I think I'm a clone now. I was just going to say, though, of course, it's a spoof of a song called I Think I'm Alone Now, which I first heard of when it came out in 1987. Tiffany did it.
Yeah.
You used to like Tiffany.
Oh, yeah.
And I didn't believe my parents because they were like, this is an old song. I was like, no, it's not. It's like number one right now. This was in 1987. And they were like, no, it came out in the 60s. And it did, of course.
Yes.
It was by Tommy James and the Shondells. It was number one in 1967. And then it was only 20 years later, 1987. Do you know it's now been 34 years since that song
came out? Well, then we need to bring that song back because it's a good one.
Is that right? 1987, 13, 21. Yeah, 34 years. That's a long time. It's time to make it number one again.
Yeah.
Anyway, so it was a hit for her, and then Weird Al did a version in 1988. But my strongest memory of this song, and I don't think this person watches, so it's probably okay. I don't know if I was a student or I was student teaching, but it was at the high school in Amherst, and there was a teacher talent show, and the teachers all got a chance to perform and stuff. And one teacher, and I won't say his name, but one teacher came out and performed this song, but he did it to a hand puppet. So he had a hand puppet, and him and the hand puppet were singing, I think I'm alone, I think we're alone now. And they would take turns singing. And I was like, who sings to their hand, I think we're alone now? Like, what were they going to get up to? Anyway, I always thought it was kind of weird.
Kamala Henderson.
I don't know. It was a little bit weird, a little bit creepy, but I can't hear that song without thinking of that school teacher singing to his hand, I think we're alone now. And the hand looked very excited, and you know it was like a little Muppet hand puppet. I keep doing it so far over you can't tell. Anyway, that's what I think of. But if you know the song I Think I'm Alone Now, you might enjoy it, and you might enjoy these new lyrics, or not new lyrics but different lyrics by Mr. Weird Al Yankovic. And this one is called I think
I'm a clone now.
There you go. Very so clever. So clever. Take it away, Heather. Oops.
Isn't it strange? Feels like I'm looking in the mirror. Cause what would people say if they only knew what I was? Part of a genesis plan, born to be a carbon copy man. There in a petri dish, late one night, they took a donor's body cell and fertilized a human egg. And so I say, I think I'm a clone now. There's always two of me just a hanging around. I think I'm a clone now, cause every chromosome is a hand-me-down. Look at the way we go out walking close together, cause what do you say? I'm really beside myself still, so remember how it all began. They produced carbon copy man, born in a science lab late one night without a mother or a father, just a test tube and a womb with a view. I think I'm a clone now, and always two of me just a hanging around. I think I'm a clone now, cause every chromosome is a hand-me-down. I think I'm a clone now, I can stay at home while I'm out of town. I think I'm a clone now, cause every pair of jeans is a hand-me-down. Signing autographs for my fans, come and meet the carbon copy man. Living in stereo, it's alright. Well, I can be my own best friend, and I can send myself a pizza, so I say, I think I'm a clone now. Another one of me just hanging around. I think I'm a clone now, cause every chromosome is a hand-me-down. I think I'm a clone now. I've been on Oprah Winfrey, I am world-renowned. I think I'm a clone now, and every pair of jeans is a hand-me-down. I think I'm a clone now, that's my genetic twin always hanging around. I think I'm a clone now, cause every chromosome is a hand-me-down.
You had fun doing that.
I did.
It's kind of fun. I never listened to the words before.
It's cute.
I'm not a Weird Al fan. But you are, and apparently other people are as well, because look at this. Look, Craig couldn't wait for it. And then Blaine said, I'm definitely a Weird Al fan.
Excellent.
Cute rendition, says Molly. Harley, thanks for the great show, guys.
Thanks for tuning in.
Thanks for watching. Do you know, I was getting discouraged because we were only getting about 10 or 12 people watching, and we've been up over 20 all night. 20 people.
That's
and
so
some
exciting.
Of you, there's like couples watching. So I bet we have 30 people watching. We're like famous. So thank you. Julie says, jammed pack night tonight. Tubi, Toenails, Bruno, Anne, and Weird Al. Love you guys. Oh, you're awesome.
Aw, thank you.
Thank you, Julie. That's very sweet of you. Craig says, Blaine, I'm a Weird Al fan too.
Honestly, one of the best concerts I ever saw was Weird Al Yankovic. It was so much fun.
Really, James Taylor was the best concert.
That was. I said one of the best.
I know. I'm just
one
saying.
Of the best.
Blaine says, nice job on those lyrics. There's a lot of them.
There are. Yeah, it's complicated.
Your tongue got twisted a little.
A little bit, yeah.
Anyway, but for the most part, you did a great show.
Thank you.
And Donna says, great show tonight. And
thank you.
Says, that was good, Heather. Well, thank you, guys. It's kind of a short show. We're going to finish at just 57 minutes.
Wow.
Sometimes we go on a long time. But I didn't do a reading this week because I was still working on Stomp and Tom, and I was like, I think our audience might be sick of Stomp and Tom, but soon I'll be writing about Sarah McLachlan, so I'll read you some
We're
stuff.
Looking forward to
I
that.
Already started with that with Heather. I was like, did you know she was adopted? I didn't know she was adopted.
Here it comes.
Get ready.
I'm so excited.
It's going to be a month of me.
But I do love Sarah McLachlan, so finally you're writing about somebody I'm actually interested in, so that's good.
But Carole Baker.
Yes, Carole
what did
Baker,
you say?
She inspired me, and now I want to, like, you know, bring Carole.
After she
and
read.
I think it's a real shame that she's basically disappeared from the music industry. Like my, I use Ultimate Guitar on my tablet to anybody who's familiar with guitar websites and stuff for
find
chords.
The chords for the songs.
There's not one single, they don't even recognize the fact that Carole Baker is a singer. So that is a crying shame because she is somebody who has had great success. Well, at least in
14
Canada.
14 number one hits.
14 number one
she
hits.
She wrote half of them.
In Canada. And I just think that it's anyway. That not even one of her songs is on here. So
anyway, we'll get back to Carole Baker. But there you go. Some more compliments there.
Thank you.
Great show tonight. Thank you. That was your cousin. And then Ginny, another fun show. We're awesome. Oh, that's sweet.
Love you guys.
Love you too, Sue.
Thank you.
Andreas is a great show. Thank you. And Carol's a great show. Thanks. And I may hit you up for a refresher on that mixer, Craig. We might try it. Maybe next week we'll have better sound.
We'll see.
Anyway, thanks for watching,
thanks,
everybody. We had fun. Hope we didn't gross you out too much.
Just my dad.
Anyway, thanks. We appreciate everybody watching. Have a great night. Stay safe out there. Keep your distance. Wash your hands and, you know, hang in there. We'll get through this. Okay. Bye-bye.